Hey you guys, John Rock and TV1 here. So on the far right is my year 2000 Dell Precision 530 MT dual Xeon processor at 2.8 gigahertz each with hyper-threading, Windows XP Professional, and 2 gig of RAM bus. The video card is a ATI all-in-one 9200 SE with video in and video out. The machine just inside of that is my 2008 or so Dell Precision T3400 with a Q3650 quad, 4 gig of memory, and soon to have this hard drive. What I am going to show you as we change right now, and we will talk about some of the hardware and the plumbing, or electrical plumbing, that if you're going to transfer VHS tapes into your computer for digitizing for either hard drive archive reasons or VHS to DVD, you need to be able to do this. So let's get at it. Okay, so most of you guys were not around my channel in 2010 when I got this machine. And like I said, it's a Dell 530 MT dual Xeon machine. And it was originally a Windows NT box. And for who, I don't know. But it has been upgraded to nearly the max that it will take. I have Audigy 2 Sound Blaster with Firewire. And it's, I believe that does 7.1 sound. It has Firewire on the sound card. I have a USB 2 Adaptec with Firewire. The machine itself also came with Firewire because it only was built with USB 1 in around 1999 or 2000 when this machine was born at Dell. USB 1 is slower than Firewire 400, which is what this is, or 1394, I believe, is what the Sony designation is, or Apple, whoever. However, that's probably why that was on there, and you can, and I have had Firewire external hard drives, and that's how you can get those in. And so, because this was only USB 1, I put the USB 2 card in, and it also had Firewire on there. So I have multiples of those, including the Firewire that's on the sound card. Okay, the machine also has, like I stated previously, a, I believe the card came out in about 2003. It is a ATI all-in-one 9200 SE, and it has VGA out, 128 megabytes, of AGP memory. It's on an AGP 4 slot. The card actually does 8, but this machine only does 4X, which doesn't really matter because we're not using it for a gaming box. We don't really care about the capabilities of the video card as a video adapter. What we care about is the fact that it is a capture card. Moving on from there, you could see this port here. This is the, this is the cable RF connector. That's where you screw your cable connector on. And this is the input connector. It's the purple one. And you use one of these purple cables. This is the breakout cable from ATI. And it has an S-video input. It has video composite or component in. And audio red and white. White and red. Audio inputs. And that goes through the card. And the ATI card has the capability either internally to on a port that's on the card, which it does not and did not come with the cable to do that, because sound cards, they all got their own different inputs on there. However, it did come with this card, also does video out. So it has on it a S video output to boot with the VGA out. It also has a composite output, so I could send the video from this machine, meaning its desktop, or through the video, out to a VCR or another computer, in which I can record what's going on in this machine onto another machine through any of these output ports. I don't remember what that this one here is. I believe it is actually audio. I don't remember. I've never used that for that. I've always been able to just send the audio. You can send it out through the green line. So this machine takes the video in this port or in the breakout cable and then, of course, processes it through the machine and sends it out, and it sends its audio through this to the line in, the blue port on your sound card. Now, for the most part, since about 2004, when I started doing this for MySpace videos, long before YouTube, I have been using a mini DV camera. And it also, for guys that are thinking of doing this VHS, this also has basically the same corresponding, this has this jack right here, which is just a breakout jack, and it's the same thing as a cable like this. It has an S video out. It has S video out, our left and right audio out, and component yellow out. So you could feed this video straight into the machine through the components. However, the preferred method for a DV camera is through the FireWire port right here. The FireWire port comes out of here and goes into one of my FireWire ports, and then I go ahead and capture AVI video from them, which is about the best you can get. It's the best quality. It's a digital transfer as it is. Doing this, you're actually converting a digital tape into an analog component signal and then back again, which is not good for quality. That being said, whoever is watching this video, you have to decide what you want to do. If you are coming from either a camera or a VCR, you have to decide what kind of quality you actually want to get. And from there, you make your decisions on these here plumbing options. For guys with newer cameras, you know, any of the HD cameras, they're all recording to an SD card. So they're either going to FireWire into the computer, or you're going to pull the SD card out and put it in a reader. So there is none of this. There's no direct. The capture is already over. This is basically for analog guys who want to take their home movies off maybe a Hi8 camera that has the component outputs on it, or a digital 8 camera, or a VCR. And that is your analog source. And in order to do that, you need an analog capture card. And from there, we're going to talk about that a little more while I change this hard drive out into my new machine. As you can see, this machine here is a bit on the old side and a little bit on the dirty side. And it's not that it doesn't work. It's just that it was born in 2000 or 1999, and I have been running it right out straight since I upgraded it in about 2012. This summer I got a video here about what I put for parts into this machine. And I think it's only a year ago or so that I put that video up. But this machine, it's not that it doesn't work, and it's not that it's old. It's that I've been using it for 24 hours a day for the last almost 10 years now. And it's time for me to consider the fact that, you know, when she blows, what am I going to put in place of it? And so we have done that with the Dell T3400. And we'll talk about that now while we change out this hard drive. Okay, so here's the inside of my, I don't know, 60, 70 pound Dell 530 dual CPUs. Xeon 2.8, Prestonius, the ATI all-in-one, 128 megabytes of memory, and the Tuna, and it is in an AGP 4 slot, which has no bearing at all on the capture properties of the machine. No bearing at all. It is a software hardware type of encoder. They ATI and the Theater 200 chip that is on there, which I actually consider the best and the end of the road for ATI as far as analog video capture goes. After this card, they did make a couple more, and we're not going to talk about that here. Well, I'm going to make another video on the reasons why I have certain ATI products, and that's it. And then we'll talk about why and how they work and what you should look for if you want to buy any of this equipment to do this job for yourself. So you don't have to send it out to somebody else and pay big bucks for it. This is my USB card right here with the FireWire on it. This is the sound card right here, an Audigy 2ZX and a LSI SAS PCIX SATA board. I have four SATA ports on there, of which I'm only using one, and we are going to, the point was to upgrade this, but I have decided since to get more hard drives, but I've decided since that I really needed to take this machine out of full-time use and move on to some newer hardware that had, you know, a little bit more time before that max time before failure day comes. And so while this machine is still perfect, and the other end of this is why I keep reinforcing the fact that you need to decide what you want to do for yourself. This machine actually is my home theater PC. It's easier for me to have all of this stuff in here and watch TV on this machine. Not only does it do my YouTube videos, but if I'm watching the History Channel or the Geographic Channel or whatever else I want to watch, or FX, or somebody puts a movie on that I want to record, like we used to do in the old days with VHS, I can then take those off of the TV, bring them into the software, and cut all the video, cut all the advertisements out, the commercials, and then have store my movies on a separate hard drive for viewing pleasure later down the road. And one of the benefits of having the amount of horsepower that I had here as compared to what I was using in 2004, a single Pentium 4 Northwood, just did not have the horsepower to crush video in real time, watch it at the same time, and make it in a storable format that I was going to buy hard drives for. Hard drives today are far cheaper than they were in 2004. And back then, I was dealing with, you know, 120 gig drives that were costing me $150 a piece. Now, that's like nothing. You can buy those for $5 off of eBay. And everybody's got terabyte drives. That means you can, of course, encode your video to the final size before you ever do anything to it, while the machine is while you're watching it and while it's capturing it. I finish my video encode while it's being done, so it doesn't have to be done. And the second time around, when I take the commercials out, all I got to do is tell it to make the same thing, and it just whizzes right through it. It's done. All it's doing is pulling the commercials out. It's already been encoded. So that's another thing, and we'll talk about that in another video. Okay, moving right along. One reason why I no longer, for machines that I want to run full-time, unless it's just a toy, I buy commercial-grade hardware anymore. And you can buy these things used, 5-6 years old, with very high-quality hardware. When they go off a lease or when a company decides they're going to upgrade. And this machine here came stock with an Ultra SCSI 160, which doesn't sound like much right now, but it's faster than two SATA 1 drives in a RAID 0. And this is a 10,000 RPM Ultra SCSI 160 hard drive. I believe it's an Atlas Fireball, 10,000 RPM. I'm just going to peel that cable out of the way for right this second. No, wait a minute. This is my IDE one. This here is my SCSI right here. But we need this drive out for right now. And this is my storage drive and my working drive from where my raw video goes to and I edit from. And so we need this drive out. It's faster for me to remove this drive in its entirety and put it right in another machine than it is to transfer it over a USB cable. And there's like, 500 gig is on this drive and it's stuffed right full. And so we don't want to wait for that. We want this drive out of here. And we're going to put it right in another machine and be its new storage home. One more perfect reason why to buy these here commercial grade hardwares. And yeah, I guess I gotta get that wire out of the way. Is it gonna make it for me? I guess I can pull that out of the way and just do that. Yeah. And then I just slide my drive out of here. Holy. No tools until you gotta save the no tools. So this is a 500 gig Hitachi drive. It's a pretty fast drive, 7200 RPM, And yeah, this came in a USB housing that I shucked years ago. But yeah, that's what we're doing. And now the inside of the almost 10 year newer machine. 4 gig of ECC memory, quad Q9650. For right now, it is a 250 gig hard drive that I bought this machine purposely off eBay, cheap money, because I knew I had the quad heatsink. I knew I had the Q9650 out of another project. It had built-in firewire and the big power supply that goes with this machine. And I knew that because the seller was selling it with Windows 7, that I would just go ahead and clone that hard drive up nicely to go on the other machine that I have that's exactly the same as this. And the Windows 7 install isn't going to know the difference at all. Why? Because I shut off the network cards. It will never see the internet. Ever. The one clone goes right into another machine. It's a clone. And it's in the real sense of the word. So, for these machines, they come with these hard drive caddies. So I need this off of here. And I'm going to take my new hard drive that I just pulled out of the other machine. That's going to be the new storage drive. And I don't have this caddy here with me. It's at another location. So I'm short one, which is fine because the machine isn't moving around anywhere. It's just going to hang out until I get that drive, that caddy there. But these kind of just slide in here like this. No tools. Once you screw the caddy to the drive, it just drops right down in here. So we're going to change that off camera. For now, for this video, we're just going to show you what's in this machine. Okay, what matters to us is the business end here. And just like the other machine, there's a reason why I am using the ATI parts, and we're going to talk about that in another video. The reasons why.
We have all three plants running pretty consistent. And that has turned out to be kind of a bit of a nightmare.
Tony, beach season has gone from bad two weeks ago. Monica shut down when she had frozen bed.
Perfect.
Done. Well, out of that.
Yep. And just last week, Kevin was.